And you can see the sign behind me here still advertising those monthly teen nights here at the water park. Now it appears those future events could be in jeopardy as police continue to investigate multiple chaotic scenes that parents find disturbing.
Them niggas still fighting.
Sounds of screaming and video showing at least two people clearly fighting outside a popular water park. These are the first videos to surface of two incidents this month at least Summit City Water Park called Summit Waves. But witnesses say the video hardly tells the whole story.
It was insanity. It was like watching a riot.
This mom named Jenny says she stayed in the parking lot after dropping off her son and saw dozens of kids jumping the fence after the park closed its gates on teen night last night because they were at capacity.
After that, it was just sheer chaos.
Her children tell her they were and held up. She spotted lights starting to close last night. She says she got even more disturbing news from one of the two off-duty cops on scene.
So I walked around to the front and asked an officer, can I go in to get my son? And he said, sure, go ahead. And he goes, but you need to grab him quickly because there's about to be some bad things happen. And he goes, I think there's going to be a shooting.
Neighbors tell us they heard multiple shots last Sunday night at what police have called a birthday party that was ending at the water park. The Parks Department didn't return our calls for comment and yet to comment on last week's shots fired investigation, but posted on social media today saying, quote, during the events of last night's teen night at Summit Waves, there were incidents inside the facility, including unpaid patrons jumping the fence and disrespectful behavior and comments towards staff and police on site. At the conclusion of the teen night event, there was a fight in the parking lot outside the facility. We will review the teen night event as a whole and determine the future of this event.
Well, they may have to get rid of that and always have their parents or some grown-up here with them so they can monitor their kids. You know, you just don't turn kids loose and because they get in too much trouble that way.
We tried to talk to more parents, but police were called to kick us off public property. I mean, they say it was at the direction of the park's director. But according to the mom who saw it all.
Would you send your son to another teen night?
Never.
Here?
Never again.
Now, no arrests were made in either of those investigations so far. We'll let you know what they find out, plus what they decide on future teen nights here. Though I can tell you that in that post, they did say they're committed to safe and responsible events for all.